Inshallah, Sheikh, we will now start with the first event, which is the public talk for junior girls. Inshallah, this is for the age group of 8 to 12 years. And inshallah, I would like to call upon the participants one by one. For the junior girls, the first participant is Sister Insha Maheen. Sister Insha, you're... Yes.
Assalamu alaikum.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته I'm Insha Maheen and today I'm going to speak on the topic Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel. Allah is enough for me. We send salutations to Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam in every prayer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him, guided him, and blessed him with sound wisdom. A young boy was put in front of a fire. The fire was so huge that he had to be placed into a catapult in order to be thrown from a safe distance. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said, when Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam was thrown into the fire, he said, Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel. Allah is enough for me and he is the best caretaker of affairs. Bukhari. A heart devoid of faith will never be able to say these words. It's only a true believer who will understand and know without a doubt that Allah alone is the one who bestows help and protection, and He alone is the remover of harm and affliction. In the Battle of Uhud, the Muslim army was under attack and almost defeated. The hypocrites were taunting the Muslims, asking them to fear the great gathering against them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recorded the conversation in Surah Al-Imran, verse number 173. So the hypocrite said, indeed, the people have gathered against you, so fear them. But it increased them in their faith. And they said, sufficient for us is Allah, and He is the best caretaker of affairs. These are the most blessed people, but tested on their faith. Let's analyze ourselves. When one of the blessings is taken from us, or if we are being tested for anything, what is our situation? We react as, why me? What did I do wrong? Why did Allah do this to me? Why are we so ready to trust others, but so quick to question Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Such questions are tainted by our false comprehension that the blessings bestowed upon us belong to us. And in an instant, it shakes our whole building of tawakkul, sometimes causing it to collapse and opening up a new door for our enemy, Shaytan. At these moments, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expects from us, one has to believe in the promise of Allah when He tells us in the Quran, chapter 65, verse number 3. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب ومن يتوكل على الله فهو حسبه إن الله بالغ أمره And whoever relies upon Allah, then He is sufficient for him. Dear brothers and sisters, relying on Allah alone, trusting Him for His decisions for us and patiently waiting for an outcome that will always be the best for us, even if it is not pleasing to us. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower on us the tawakkul like Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and guide all of us to the right path and choose us as the chosen ones. Ameen ya Rabbul Alameen. Wa assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi
wa barakatuh.
MashaAllah.